Hi, I'm Lisa Scullin, and I'm here to tell you about amazing opportunities at Milton Hershey School. At some point in your life, you've probably had a Hershey's chocolate bar. You may have even ridden a roller coaster at Hershey Park. Well, these things came from the mind of Milton Hershey, and they directly benefit what Mr. Hershey called his greatest accomplishment, Milton Hershey School. Unable to have children of their own, Mr. Hershey and his wife Catherine decided to use their wealth to create a home and school for orphan boys. More than 100 years and almost 10,000 alumni later, the school's students are still provided for. But unlike when the school was founded, it is no longer only for orphan children. This private, cost-free home and school serves children from families of low income and limited resources. Currently, the school enrolls nearly 2,000 students from pre-kindergarten through 12th grade. It's a residential school, which means the students live on campus. In addition to their housing, students are provided with free meals, free clothing, and free medical and dental care. There's also no cost for music lessons, no cost for activities, no cost for participation in any sport. Someone who took full advantage of the academics and athletics at Milton Hershey School is Gary Gilliam, who now plays football for Penn State.
The road to Happy Valley is not always a pleasant one. Take the case of Penn State offensive tackle Gary Gilliam. Before he became a 6'6", 300-pound football player, Gilliam was a small, scared 7-year-old whose mother enrolled him at Milton Hershey School in 1999.
And at that point, I felt abandoned, felt like I was alone, and had a lot of questions. Why me? What did I do? Does my mom not want me anymore? Will I ever see her again? Why'd she ship me away to this strange place with these strange people? And as I grew up,
questions that only his mother knew the answers to. Her reasons for sending Gary away were simple, but not easy.
When she was dropping me back off,
she was a single mother, working full time, and caring for Gary's younger brother, a child with special needs. She wanted the best for Gary and realized that living in a rough neighborhood in Harrisburg and hanging out with the wrong crowd was not the right path for her son. But his mother's decision was hard on a young boy's heart.
I would actually hold a picture of her in a perfume box and just look at it and smell it because I miss her so much and I cried every night.
But at Milton Hershey, Gary would thrive, both academically and athletically, surrounded and encouraged by caring adults. As a student, he consistently made the honor roll. And as an athlete, he made college programs notice. But playing for a school where parents typically don't attend games, the stands behind the sideline can be sparse. But there was always one familiar face.
Mrs. Ainsworth, she's my junior chapel leader. Definitely my second mom. She was at every sporting event, even the away ones that maybe two people were out, her, my mom, and maybe somebody else. She was always there.
But our kids need to look up there and hear someone cheering for them. And really consistency, someone who's gonna be there, snow, sleet, rain, you know, I'm gonna be there because they need it.
These days, Gary plays in front of tens of thousands of fans, a far cry from the typical road game of his high school career. And just like every team has a game plan, Gary has one of his own. He dreams of playing football in the NFL, but if he doesn't, this all-academic Big Ten student will graduate as a triple major with degrees in business, advertising, and psychology. Gary never forgets to remember where he's from, often returning to Milton Hershey to encourage parents of current students.
Obviously, Milton Hershey can benefit a lot of kids around the country. And I mean, I'll do my best and have done my best to kind of get the word out about Milton Hershey and what a great place it is.
Our graduates are quick to mention how the school has given them opportunities they normally would not have been given. For example, in addition to the excellent academic education they receive, all students are required to follow a career technical pathway to give them an edge in today's competitive workforce. and we have 11 different areas they can study, ranging from law, public safety and security, to automotive technology, to health science. This training provides real skills to our students. Alex Hyder is one graduate who was prepared to enter the workforce right after high school. Doug Lagore shares Alex's story.
As a television news photographer with WCNC in North Carolina, Alex Hyder gets to experience what most people only watch on TV.
It's something different every day, but I definitely have fun doing it.
But fun isn't how Alex describes his life as a young boy. When Alex was 7, he moved in with his aunt and uncle. A few years later, he would live with his grandparents. It was then that Alex's story took a tragic turn. On December 16, 2001, at the age of 40, his father died of a heart attack. And just 3 days later, on the morning of his father's funeral, Alex's grandfather also died. Within 1 week, this 11-year-old boy would be a pallbearer at both their funerals.
At Milton Hershey School, he's not just getting a great education.
Soon afterwards, while listening to the radio, his aunt would hear something that would change her nephew's life. It was a commercial for Milton Hershey School.
I mean, even after coming and looking at the school, I was determined that I didn't want to go, which I think a lot of kids have that feeling whenever they first come, but I think I was different. I really didn't want to come here.
Hi, I'm Alex Hyder.
But he did, and he stayed. And it was at Milton Hershey that he discovered his passion, telling stories on Spartan TV, the school's television station.
I don't even remember what class it was, but I'd sign up for a class, and that's it. I was hooked.
Alex would go on to interview celebrities like Tim McGraw and Faith Hill, and he would be recognized for his storytelling by the Student Emmy Awards. And just weeks after his high school graduation, he went to work for a TV station in Harrisburg.
I knew I wanted to work in TV. I knew I didn't want to go to college because I believe, you know, college isn't for everybody. If I have the skills that I need to do what I want to do that I got from the school here, I didn't need to go. So it definitely, it's neat to see everything again. And honestly, there's some better equipment in here than where I've ever worked. And this is where we had the kids show, right?
Alex often returns to visit the place it prepared him for his future.
That's too cool. I almost forgot about that one.
And to take a moment to remember where it all began.
The school might not be for everybody, and it's definitely not. But there are kids that it will help, and it will change their lives. And I'm one of them. And I know many, 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 many kids whose lives have been changed because of this school. I would not be here where I am with the job I have without the school.
When we come back, we'll show you what it means to be a house parent at Milton Hershey School.
My name is Tracy Johnson, and I have 3 children that go to Milton Hershey School. I did research into it, and the more research I did, the more I liked the school. I know they will have every chance to succeed through Milton Hershey. Quite often I get the comment, how can you give your kids away? I haven't given them away, and I'm giving them wings so they can fly.
This is Bethany's picture from this year. And I apologize, I haven't had a chance.
On a cold fall day in rural Adams County.
But that's Bethany's.
Kelly Elkins is looking through her children's school pictures.
Devin, he's a go-getter. Benjamin, creative. Austin, he's my little Linus. Bethany, yeah, she's a little princess.
4 of Kelly's children are enrolled in Milton Hershey School, a school that she says answered her prayers over and over again.
Every time I got the phone call, you know, that they had gotten accepted, it was a prayer answered. You know, you're
not an easy decision for this mom, who doesn't like to miss a moment. But Kelly has not only given a gift to her children.
I've started a career in college.
She is now giving a gift to herself.
I mean, that school not only benefits the children that attend, but also the family.
Kelly is an honor student at Harrisburg Area Community College. She is studying to become a registered nurse. It's an achievement that she could not have pursued had it not been for the help of Milton Hershey.
It means support. It means security, it means stability, it means a future for my children, and also for me.
A bright future that Kelly is proud to share with her children.
If Mr. and Mrs. Hershey were here, I would hug them. They couldn't have children, but boy, did they help so many other people's children.
What I love about my house parents is that they've been
supporting, loving, caring.
They were always open to wanting to talk to us if we were having problems. Devoted.
I definitely think this has to be more than just a job to you.
You have to love what you do. I love my house parents because they were always there for us.
I think I'll remember my house parents forever because they're like my mom and dad.
They deeply cared about what we wanted and what we were looking for as a student.
House parents get to see the impact they've made in the students' lives.
Become a house parent at Milton Hershey School.
Welcome back. When students come to Milton Hershey, they live in large homes just like this one. There are separate homes for boys and girls, and the students live with other children of similar age. They're cared for by house parents who watch over the students when they're out of the classroom. One of our house parents, Deanna Slammons, knows what it's like to live in a student home, both as a house parent and a student. Here's her story. An early photo of Deanna Slammons shows a young girl wearing pigtails and a smile. But pictures don't always imitate life. When Deanna was just 7, her mother took her own life. Prison had already taken Deanna's father.
We were living in the projects at that time when my mom passed away. And that same year in May, my grandmother, who was also our caregiver, had passed away. So we really had nobody at the time that my aunt came to get us.
She and her sisters would leave the only home they had known.
We had moved that summer to Harrisburg, and it wasn't that December that I got hit by a car.
Battered both physically and emotionally, a 7-year-old's life shouldn't know that much pain. Pain her aunt knew would take time to heal.
She figured, you know, with so much trauma, let's not send them to Milton Hershey School right away. She had known about it when I was 7, turning 8 years old, but she waited.
In 1986, when the time to enroll finally came, Milton Hershey School was a new place, a fresh start.
I kind of felt like I could be a kid again. Not that I had grown up, but I felt like, okay, wow, I can still play. I don't have to be dealing with life's heavy issues and problems all the time. So I looked forward to it when I enrolled.
The foundation for Deanna's bright future was built with the love of her house parents at Student Home Limestone. Memories made there would rewrite her life story. Years later, Deanna would share the story of Milton Hershey School with her husband and tell how the air smelled like chocolate and the school's children were provided for. He didn't believe her, so the couple took a trip back to Deanna's Hershey home.
It was quiet in the car. He was just processing the whole campus and said, oh, it is what you said it was. It really is that big and it really is that amazing. He said, would you consider being a house parent one day?
That question had an answer. And now, 14 years later, they're still house parents, helping raise 12 high school boys in one of the school's many supersized homes.
So as a house parent, when the kids come home, I want to know about their day. I want to know the good and the bad. I want to know what they're struggling with. So everything is bigger, but it is a home.
A big home where they're helping to build big memories. In addition to house parents, there are plenty of adults who are willing to offer guidance, support, and care to our kids. One family who knows what that feels like is the Asimani family. Armand, Kayvon, and Layla, who like many children here, arrived due to circumstances beyond their control. But because of some caring adults on campus, they found a way to turn tragedy into thankfulness.
We all came to Milton Hershey School from somewhere else. There's a reason why we're here and we're not there. Something went wrong.
For the Asimani family, that something happened in July 2005. And for the years that have followed, Armand and his younger siblings have shared motherless Mother's Days.
I haven't really had a mother for the past 6 years, 7 years. And I live with 2 brothers and a male cousin. And sometimes it just gets hard to learn how to do things.
It's always been a hard thing for me to grasp a mother figure, somebody who I could really look up to as a mother figure, just because of certain things that have happened.
As an older brother, Armand struggles to fill the role of a parent.
I can only teach my sister so much about being a lady. She needs a woman to step in and teach her those skills, those roles. I can only teach my younger brother what it means to be a man up to your 20-year-old birthday.
Fortunately, at Milton Hershey School, Armand says there's no shortage of role models. For him, it was his house parents, the McLaughlins. Kayvon gives credit to his house parents, the Ogles. And for Layla, it's Cindy Stang, an elementary speech teacher. She was there for Layla's junior prom.
I see her standing down the brick sidewalk with a camera. I saw her pull my date aside and just said, "Isn't she beautiful on the inside and out?" And that just meant a lot to me.
Armand says that despite what he calls the fault line in his family, there's no time to focus on their losses. Instead, they're too busy appreciating everything that they've been given.
You have to find every chance you get to show somebody that you appreciate them. And I think Mother's Day and Father's Day is a great opportunity.
So now on every Mother's Day, they remember to write cards to all the women who have meant so much and have taught them, cared for them, and loved them, just like their own mother would.
Armand Asimani is currently attending Villanova University, but even with good grades and financial aid, the cost of a college education can be overwhelming for most families. In just a minute, we'll show you how Milton Hershey School is helping graduates afford a college education.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Heher. I am a graduate of the class of 1988, and the most important thing that Milton Hershey School gave me was a home to come home to. Everybody knew we were from the same circumstance, so it didn't matter who you were, where you came from, we were all the same. So it was unique, very special. We're all brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter what color you are, what religion you are, it doesn't matter. Everybody is the same. And that, I think that's what makes it special. If the world could be like Milton Hershey School, there'd be nothing wrong.
Milton Hershey School has a long history of students working with animals. Older alumni love to talk about their early morning cow milking chore sessions. These days, the milking chores are gone, but there are many opportunities for kids to work with animals.
It's safe to say that not every school has a barn on their campus, but Milton Hershey School does. And the chance to work with animals is appealing to kids from rural families as well as those from large cities. Through the school's agriculture and environmental programs, students in AEE can learn how to tap trees for syrup making, they can grow and harvest fruits and vegetables on our farmlands, and they can raise animals to show at the Pennsylvania Farm Show. Here's a closer look at the AEE program.
I tell people all the time that I work at Milton Hershey School, and they say, "Oh, so you're a teacher, or are you a house parent?" And I'm like, "Not really, I work on the farm." And they're like, "They have animals?"
The Milton Hershey Animal Center is home to more than 70 animals, ranging from beef cattle to barn cats. On this day, when the temperature is pushing 100 degrees and fans are in fashion, you'll find 12 kids feeding, cleaning, and milking the animals. They find out quickly that this place is not a petting zoo.
So they do understand that we are a fully functioning farm, and that if they were to come down and join club or work with us, they would be actively involved in taking care of the animals.
I am
like overjoyed that I came here. I love it so much.
They are milking the goats right now.
Milking the dairy goats is sophomore Brielle Briggs' job today. An experience she could never have imagined growing up in her hometown near Pittsburgh.
I love animals in general, and like any chance like I get to work around them, like I enjoy it. Like even if it's like cleaning up poop or something, like.
Spencer Gallitz's size and strength comes in handy not just when he's playing football and wrestling for the Spartans.
It's relatively clean over here.
But also when it's time to move the cows.
There's nothing on the ground to pull from.
Spencer lived and worked on a farm in rural Vermont before coming to Milton Hershey. Now he says he has more options for his future.
And I know now that I can do so many more things that can make me so much more successful and make me have a happier life, because I love engineering, I love animals. Mixing those two together, that'd be great if I could do that.
Working with animals teaches students much more than just how to throw hay or how many buckets of milk a goat can give.
It teaches you a work ethic. And I think with work ethic comes more responsibility, more maturity. If we set that now, I think we'll be more successful in school and in college.
Excuse me.
Which is something that was not in Brielle's future. But now, armed with the financial support of Milton Hershey and the knowledge learned from the Animal Center, she hopes to become a large animal veterinarian.
This school will set you up for the rest of your life, and it teaches you lessons you'll never forget.
In a recent survey of college pricing, it was reported that the average cost to attend an in-state college was more than $22,000 per year. A private college was almost double that. A burden for any family, let alone those who struggle financially. Milton Hershey School does what it can to help graduates through our Continuing Education Scholarship, or CES. In the cases of MHS graduates Ashlyn Trimmer and Larry Klomps, it's allowed them to realize their dreams of a college education.
Ashlyn Trimmer grew up in the small town of Enola, just across the river from Harrisburg. It was there that she and her twin brother, Derek, would play in the town's alleyways or at the park. Playtime came easy, but life at home with a struggling single mom was hard.
It just wasn't a good environment for us to be in anymore, and she couldn't really take care of us.
1,000 miles away, just north of Tampa, Florida, Larry Klomps and his brother were also struggling.
We're just kind of figuring out what we're going to eat that day, and I would either starve or we would find a friend's to go eat at.
Both Ashlyn and Larry were searching for stability, and they found it when they enrolled at Milton Hershey School. With the help of dedicated teachers, they thrived academically.
Yeah, they're great. I miss them. They've always been there.
And Milton Hershey School would be there for Ashlyn and Larry financially too. While at MHS, they both received money for college thanks to the Continuing Education Scholarship. Students can earn more than $80,000 and use it for full-time study towards an accredited undergraduate program.
Right now I'm a first-year medical student at the Penn State Milton S. Hershey College of Medicine. Now that I'm in medical school and I'm taking out a substantial amount of loans every year to cover my education, not having the financial burden of undergrad kind of looming over me as well allows me to sleep a little bit better at night. If I was asked that Milton Hershey School is a lifesaver for my brother and me, I would definitely have to say yes 10 times over.
I'm at Bucknell University. It's a beautiful place.
It's there that Ashlyn is majoring in accounting while she counts the blessings that Milton Hershey School has given her and her twin brother.
Because I wouldn't be at Bucknell. I had a great first year and I'm really looking forward to my next 3 years here. That wouldn't be possible without MHS and all the opportunities that I had when I was there. Thanks, MHS.
Larry's younger brother, Vince, is an MHS graduate and a student at Lehigh University, where he is studying neuroscience. Ashlyn's brother, Derek, is attending school at Virginia Wesleyan. Coming up next, we'll meet Chris Cook, Milton Hershey School's first female graduate.
At the end of the day, when you reflect on how you spent your time, did you make a difference? Milton Hershey School House parents do every day. Find out if you're up to it. Find out if you can make a difference.
When Milton Hershey School was founded in 1909, it was to house and educate orphan boys. But in 1977, girls were admitted for the first time. Chris Cook remembers what it was like to attend Milton Hershey School as one of the few girls on campus. For 72 years, only boys had graduated from Milton Hershey School. But that all changed with the class of 1981.
There were 13 girls, 113 boys. And also by virtue of the alphabet, since my maiden name is Brennan, I was actually the first girl technically to walk across the stage and receive a diploma from Milton Hershey School.
This stage was a long way from the Philadelphia Row House where Chris Cook grew up, one of four children living with a widowed mother. Her dad had died of a heart attack when Chris was just 4 years old. 3 years later, her brother Tom enrolled at Milton Hershey. She and her mother would visit Tom on many occasions, but it wasn't until 1979 that Chris was admitted. 2 years later, she would receive her diploma, the first female graduate to do so.
All right, today we're going to read this story called The Kissing Hand by Audrey Penn.
In 1986, Chris would return to Milton Hershey School, this time as a kindergarten teacher.
I don't want to go to school. He told his mother, I want to stay home with you. Please, may I stay home with you?
She shares her story with her students, which helps them make their transition a little easier.
Do you remember feeling a little like Chester when you started school?
Yes.
She's also big on making memories.
And every year at the end of the year, my children take home a DVD with all the pictures and all the movies I've taken of the kids all year. So I try to capture losing a first tooth or field trips that they go on and things that the parents don't get to see.
27 years since she started teaching at the school which taught her so much, her love for her students is clear. So is the love for the school that welcomed her as its first female graduate.
It is very safe to say that Milton Hershey School has had an impact on me. From visiting as a little second grader to teaching here for 27 years. Yeah, I love the mission of the school. I love the opportunity to help kids. I love the feeling a little bit of giving back, to a school that's given me so much.
We hope you've learned a little bit more about Milton Hershey School and the amazing opportunities that it provides for children in need. If you'd like more information on how to enroll a student or how to become a house parent, go to our website, mhskids.org. You can also follow us on Facebook. Again, thanks for watching and letting us share with you the amazing opportunities at Milton Hershey School.